On the edge of Joshua Tree National Park, in the middle of the Mojave Desert in Southern California, there are a lot of orbs, spirit orbs. Some people would say the spirits of long-gone Native Americans that used to live here by the thousands, for thousands of years. Other people think they're nature spirits. They tend to the plants, everything that grows. They have a lot to do with that. Some of them look just like comets. I've seen a lot of orbs online, but nothing like what happens around this neighborhood that I took these pictures at. All kinds of things manifest. Look at these strange ones. Now, you have to use a flash to photograph them. They become phosphorescent, luminescent with light just long enough to be photographed digitally. They seem to operate on the infrared level. At first I thought they were rain or dust, but then I studied up and I realized that there was something very strange going on here. And then it just started getting stranger and stranger. These orbs, I'm able to photograph them anytime, any night. They're here in this area adjacent to the national park. It's a very desolate area. Now, these guys showed up one night. Look at the trails, they're identical. These are like some kind of beings of light. They have, they glow from within. They have some sort of inner luminescence that, it's just a really huge energy source. These just showed up in my backyard before the sun went down at around dusk one day. And this is when I knew something really odd was happening. Look at the trails, how identical the trails are. Nothing on this movie is photoshopped. This is all just as it came out in the camera. And these comet-like ones, they seem to have a major consciousness. Some of the other ones just sort of drift around, but these comet-like ones, they're always on the move. And the different colors that they come in. Now, sometimes, these orbs will get together like this, and just in these really intense colors, reds and oranges, and drift together. This is just, they're hovering just over my backyard fence right here. Just the colors are just mind-blowing. Sometimes they look like photos from the Hubble telescope. So for a while there, I was pretty sure I was living in the orb capital of the planet. They love the full moon. That's the full moon with a big blue orb. All of a sudden I caught this one night and I said to my friend Piper, that looks like a fairy. And it does. It looked like a fairy to me, with wings and legs and arms or antenna, just cruising by the full moon. Then I took the next picture and whatever it was got between the camera and the full moon. And there's a little orb right in front of it, too. It seems to be following. I said, boy, that looks like a fairy. Now, my friend Piper is a fairy freak. She's like, everyone calls her the Fairy Queen. So we brought her down there and took some photos, and sure enough, the orbs seemed to really like her. They were everywhere. So we're pretty happy campers with these photos. Then she decided to try to invoke a fairy by saying, "I'm a fairy too, I'm a fairy too." And I snapped this picture, and we both said, "What's that on the roof? This is not Photoshop. That was really there. It's really there." That's what's known as a butterfly fairy. That's a fairy queen. They're a monarchy, according to the fairy experts I've been studying since this all happened. They're a monarchy. And they have drones, and they have workers. They're organized a lot like bees. And they help things grow. In India, they're known as devas. In the English-speaking world, they're known as nature spirits. When put through some processing, digital processing software, they got some incredible effects. Some of the auras in the software, it's just too much. And there's no anomaly, pixelation anywhere. Like I said, this is not Photoshop. Look at this one. You can almost see the transparency in the wings. It almost looks like veins are in the wings. Now here's a really interesting one. To a lot of people, this looks like a human-like figure with its arms and hands in the air, its left knee bent, its head turned to the left all the way, so it's in profile. Took these after I told him what was going on. Several miles away. Figure this is the fairy queen. There's also a fairy known as the night bat fairy. It runs with bats. It likes the thrill of the hunt, although it doesn't eat insects, of course. But Piper took a picture of one. It just popped up in a photo. She was out there photographing orbs. Bat fairy. Bats and fairies have been long associated all through history. That fairy actually assumes the shape of a bat. It seems they can shapeshift at will. These beams of light. That are visible just outside our range of sight. Piper took this photo These are orbs imitating bats, just like messing with our minds. We found it pretty funny. Those are all tiny orbs traveling together, manifesting as green bats. Here's another bat-like manifestation. These are all circular orbs joined together. This is through some software. The prism-like effects are pretty cool. Close up, it looks like tiny stars make everything up. Tiny little brilliant stars. A lot of times, the fairies will manifest as jewels, like glowing a jewel. Totally different than the average orb. Here's one right here. It's just all by itself next to a tree. Here it is, blown up. I mean, that is a jewel. It's hard to get good close-ups of orbs. I was lucky to get a few. Some people see faces in them. I've never really been sure about that. Here's the full moon. Look at the color of that blue orb. And look at this strange manifestation one night. I caught this one night. It almost looks like fluttering wings. Here's another fairy manifesting like a jewel. Comets were on the move this night. I believe these are like drones and workers that accompany the fairy queen on her rounds. Look at these large translucent orbs in the foreground during a full moon, just before dusk. Here's a fairy manifesting as a heart. Here's some three-dimensional orbs. Look at the colors on this one. Fairies are real. I'm convinced. There's a lot of different dimensions going on. Right here. Wherever you are.